This conference will now be recorded.
I'd like to welcome everyone to the June 20th, 2023 regular council meeting. I'll call it to order at 7 p.m. All rise for the pledge of allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, any additions or corrections to the agenda? If none, I'd like to make a motion to accept the agenda tonight.
I'll move to accept the agenda as written.
So moved. Is there a second?
Second.
Seconded by Counselor Norman. Would you call a roll, please, Stephanie?
Norman?
Aye.
Counselor Wagner?
Aye.
Mayor Plummer?
Aye.
Counselor Ash?
Aye.
Counselor Webb?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Okay, any presentations tonight, Steph? None? Moving right into the public hearing. The budget. Let's go ahead and read this formality and begin. Do I need the time on the hearing, Steph?
Just start with your script.
Okay. This is the time scheduled for a public hearing regarding acceptance of the City of Vernonia fiscal year 2023-2024 city budget as presented by staff. We will now take public testimony. Each person will be allowed 5 minutes. After everyone has had the opportunity to speak, we will close the public hearing and deliberate. The following are the rules of order. Number one, no person shall speak without being first recognized by the chair and stating his or her name, full name, and residence of address. Two, no person shall be disorderly, abusive, or disruptive of the orderly conduct of the hearing. Three, there shall be no audience demonstrations such as applause, cheering, display, signs, or conduct disruptive of the hearing. Such conduct may be grounds for immediate termination of the hearing by the council. Four, no person shall present irrelevant, immaterial, or unduly repetitious oral argument. Five, the mayor, members of the council, and with the approval of the chair, the city attorney, and any other officer or employee of the city may question any person who submits oral argument. Six, the council may set time limitations for this proceeding, but in doing so must provide proponents and opponents equal time to present arguments. The time limit set will be 30 minutes. We will now take public testimony. In order to use our time efficiently, you are requested not to repeat testimony or read testimony already submitted in writing. Okay. Prior to addressing the council, each person shall come to the podium, state his or her name and address, which will become public record. After everyone has had the opportunity to speak, we will close the public hearing and begin deliberations. Are there any proponents who wish to speak in favor of acceptance of the City of Vernonia fiscal year 2023-2024 city budget as presented by staff? Look like there are. Are there any opponents who wish to speak against the acceptance of the City of Vernonia fiscal year 2023-2024 city budget as presented by the staff? With that being none, I'll move right on. Is there anyone who is neither for nor against the acceptance of the City of Vernonia fiscal year 2023-2024 city budget as presented by the staff? Is there any rebuttal from the staff? This concludes the public testimony and oral argument portion of the hearing. I will now close the public hearing at 7:05 p.m. We will now begin deliberations, but.
Really, you can deliberate, but really the decision's going to be under resolutions and ordinances.
Okay.
It's up to you.
Does anyone have any comments or anything to add before we move on to the, in the agenda? Okay, moving on. Mayor's report. Time for Citizen of the Month recognition. I believe Counselor Webb had the honor and duty of choosing a citizen for the month of June, which we're in now. So with no further ado, I'll turn it over to Counselor Webb.
All right. Well, I'd like to thank my fellow counselors for leaving me a really easy one here. I was a little dumbfounded when I was going down our list of citizens of the month, and I noticed my candidate's name wasn't on the list, and I was surprised. So sometimes, you know, you have to kind of think about, oh, who am I going to do next time? And I have something common with this person that I selected when I was out running around watering trees one day. And I was like, man, I understand how much time this person's put in dragging hoses around and filling bags and doing different things. And, you know, that was what spurred my idea of, and I thought surely he was on the list, but nope, he wasn't. So this person retired here in Vernonia back in 2003. He came from the education field. He was a dean of schools of 1,000 students. He never says where, but anyhow, he also stepped forward, was a city councilor during the 2000 flood time period. He retired here, but then he didn't really retire because I think he taught for 11 years in the school system here.
13 in Oregon, 34 in Colorado.
Yeah.
34 in where, Steve?
Colorado.
Oh.
Paris, that's kind of where. He's also an author, has 6 books. I'm jealous. He's been a school board member. Been on our parks committee. And this is the one that was really interesting. People always have interesting things in their life, especially if they just don't live their whole lives in Vernonia. He was a NASA teacher, worked on the mission design for the Galileo space program. He says a very minor part. That still was, I mean, almost a rocket scientist, almost. So on the trees, what he told me is he gathered donations for about 4 years. I think you spearheaded kind of the design of the layout of where the trees should go and approach the city. And of course, then once the trees arrived, somebody needed to water them. So, and I'm not too sure you're still not watering some down there.
It does come up in conversation.
Yeah. For at least 3 years, he was watering trees with his wife, Sue, which helped a lot. So down in our Spencer Park. And you go down there now and you can start to see what that's going to become. It's going to be spectacular. And for that, the other part why I selected Mr. Whiteman was not only just the volunteering, but it's the visionary ideas. That was a visionary idea. I think the pavilion down at Spencer Park, that's a visionary idea. You probably had others, I'm sure, that I'm not aware of, but, and that's a good role for a citizen in town to lead. Well, the other visionary idea is the senior health home. You spurred that discussion. So I appreciate that. And we need people that step up and volunteer, but also can lead us down certain paths with great ideas and supply information. So my citizen of the month for June is Steve Whiteman. Which way you want to go?
Probably this way.
Sorry. I'll let you hold it.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hold on, I'm going to get a few because Scott will be like, why don't you?
Yeah, I always go that way.
Horizontal is for the website. Theme.
All right, thank you.
All right, thank you.
Thank you, Dave.
Steve, all those trees got water and stakes today.
I saw that. Got a text for that thing, thanks. And right after I said, it's getting dry and there are thunderstorms.
Hey, can't hurt.
All I have to do is get dry and then you bring on the storms.
Yeah.
You have magic.
Yeah. I did a rain dance in my office.
Before you run off, I have a funny story about Steve Whiteman. So.
There we go.
My in-laws live in. I'll make it pretty quick. So my in-laws live in Durango, Colorado, and we were at the post office sending off some books, well, many boxes of books back home. And it's a great little, it's like our little post office, very friendly. Everybody knows everybody. And I pull up there and I'm handing it up at the counter and he goes, Vernonia. Vernonia, Oregon. Yeah. She goes, I know somebody who used to work here in near Durango as a teacher. I said, do you know Steve Whiteman? I laughed because I was on the board with Steve at the time. I said, well, as a matter of fact, yes, I do. So, yes, she commented how much she appreciated you. I don't remember her name, but it was just very funny that small world. Yeah. I'm glad you ended up here. Because you were very helpful. My daughter was very blessed to have had you for geometry. The only math class she ever liked and did well in.
By the way, if you have a Reader's Digest that came in the last 2 days, there's a Monomi guy who wrote a joke that actually stayed there. I have one.
Congratulations, that is not easy.
They sent another one in today. It was yesterday, my wife for 56 years, and I poured concrete. Today we have a problem. We don't know who we buried under the slab or why.
Thank you, Dale.
Yep.
Council committee meeting reports.
I missed library. I'm sorry. I was on an airplane.
Sure. I have one. I went to the senior board meeting last week. That's Friday. We did have a quorum, which was good. There was some discussion in, there's only about one or two, maybe three people that kind of do everything down there. And so if somebody's not there present, and it could be a problem, you know. So they talked about, they had a good idea about forming a continuity book, which kind of lays out the protocols and what to do and what not to do. And so there was good discussion there. The oven door's been replaced. Thank you. They were happy about that. They served a total of 580 meals last month. Things are pretty much improving just a little bit at the thrift store. I think they had, last month they had thrift income of 34,41.50. So it's slowly getting back up to normal. There is a craft sale on the 24th of June from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. in the parking lot. So that's about all I have on. And the next meeting's July 14th. We're doing pretty good down there at the chamber. I didn't make the library meeting. I don't know if they had one.
Cemetery, you mean?
No, cemetery, I mean.
I think they did.
Okay. Okay, yeah, I got short notice on it, like the day before, and I'd already made other plans. Hopefully next month I'll hear from them, so. Okay, topics on the floor tonight? No. Consent agenda for acceptance, none. Consent agenda for approval. City Council meeting minutes for June 5th, 2023. Be found on page 1 through 4. Any questions, discussions? If not, would anyone like to make a motion to accept the June 5th meeting minutes?
I'll move to accept the June 5th council meeting minutes.
So moved. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Council Webb, second. Call the roll, please, Stephanie.
Mayor Hobart?
Aye.
Councilor Ash?
Aye.
Councilor Webb?
Aye.
Councilor Wagner?
Aye.
Councilor Norman?
Aye.
Okay, any unfinished business? No. New business, A, street closure request. Rachel Oregon is here with us. Page 5. Everybody had a chance to review this application? Any questions for staff on this?
Or from Ms. Oregon?
Actually, it's a staff question. So police department has no problem with closing a street down for them?
No, because it'll just be barricades. And then if they had to get emergency services through, they could. Just safety for the residents. And Rachel, you want to say that you talked to all the neighbors?
Yeah, I kind of went and talked to the last one. They're either coming or they're gone and they don't care. But yeah, I went and knocked on everybody's door.
Oh, good.
I said council's going to care whether all the neighbors know and, you know, are okay with it.
Yeah. We had some of the ones on the end. It's mostly because it's been okay, but last year people were just driving right over the fireworks and pretty fast. And the kids are out running around. And I was like, well, maybe because people wanted to have a shindig. And I thought, well, we're going to really be spilling into the street. We should probably. See if we can shut it down.
It's a good idea.
But I've told everyone no rowdiness, no big fireworks, no itch. But most of my streets and investors were pretty low. It shouldn't get rowdy.
Okay. Dale?
Yeah, I mean, I had a kind of an initial concern. I mean, I understand, but I mean, you know, where would we put the line? Everybody wants to close their street for that. I mean.
Yeah, you could. I mean, we used to do it when I was a kid. We would petition the city and do a street dance or a whatever. And there's no, everybody could if they wanted to. I mean, you wouldn't close the collectors.
Right.
Probably only close small. You probably would never close Bridge or Nehalem or Rose, but you could close the in-betweens and that wouldn't really cause any hardship as long as the people that live on there are okay with it.
Yeah.
And that's why I told her to go ask everyone because you don't want the one neighbor that doesn't want to close ruining it for, you know, everybody. If they were really going to be against it, we'd need to know what we're up against. But
we said we'd move the barrier so that people needed to come and go because some people said they might not come right back from the parade. And I said, that's fine. We'll just move the gin and put it back. They're not super big, right?
No. They're just folding metal ones.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's no, I mean, you could allow everybody to, and it wouldn't really, as long as the people that are affected by it don't mind, then.
That's the only concern I was just.
Okay.
I
I kind of have the line like Dale is, and I think maybe in the future that we get, it sounds kind of silly, but probably should get a written permission slip from all the neighbors, so that way we're not assuming what people are telling us.
Sure. So typically, we don't currently have that as part of the policy, but we could add that. Just I, you know, concur to the application filled out on this date or whatever, because this is the only form we've ever had for temporary street closure. And only other ones I've heard of is like when I close Park Drive for Salmon Fest, but I go talk to those people, but I could see you might want to have like a, or a list of the addresses and just signatures from the neighbors on one sheet or something. We could add that to the process.
Yeah, I think that would give us a black and white sheet in case somebody come down and said, well.
I didn't say okay, yeah.
Yeah.
That wouldn't be too hard, because I had to go walk and ask everybody anyway. I don't think.
Yeah.
So devil's advocate, what if somebody said no? What if you've got 12 neighbors? What if you have 20 neighbors and one says no and the rest say yes?
I just want to.
Well.
It's not worth it to have one angry neighbor.
Okay. Or somebody's not available. They're on vacation for 2 weeks ahead of time or a month ahead of time. That happens.
Yeah.
You're not able to get in touch with them. I
think we could look, I mean, what we could do if that's a concern of councils, look what other cities do. I'm sure someone's worked this out and has a policy that, you know, if it's for the greater good of a, you know, like if one Park Drive, if the one that doesn't have any parking on Park Drive was to say no and block everyone from coming down for Salmon Festival, maybe there's some quantifier that's in the policy.
Yeah.
I think Sherwood doesn't even make you ask. They have a friend that does this every year with their, and they don't have, they just go apply for the permit and they.
Yes.
You know?
Yeah.
Then you go to council.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So we could see what other.
Yeah, and that could be too.
I'm not super concerned. It's.
No, I'm not.
It's not like if this becomes a big thing and everyone's asking every week, that's obviously a different thing, but it's a holiday and it's a small residential strip. Small beans.
Does our policy spell that they got to come in front of council?
Yeah, all street closures have to. But we could. You know, added if it's for a short window or it's, you mean you guys can work on it this winter, right?
Yeah.
What that policy needs to include. That'd be easy.
I personally would recommend against it. Sorry.
Yeah. I
recommend against what?
Against having any
further policy.
Yeah. I personally feel that this is good enough, and if it's working, don't try to fix it kind of thing. Yeah,
if that's a rowdy near you, Will, he can be like, no.
That's where we draw the line.
He can still tell me no.
I think it's more apt to cause some issues if you had a form where they're.
Well, I mean, you could just have it on the back of this form, you know, if that's. And that's just for you guys to decide. I can't really tell if there's a majority, so we'll just leave it open and bring it to you guys at a later date.
Okay.
If you still want to talk about it. Maybe it does become a rager and you decide never to let it happen again. Yeah. Those organs, they're a crazy bunch.
It's all people with little children and people are in bed by 8:30,
so. Yeah.
Well, I just think it's the position of this council to make policy. I mean, we're sitting here every time deciding, and again, person comes to us, wants to close it off, and they say, well, I didn't talk to anybody else. You know, now that I got a little heartburn, maybe.
Yeah. Well, I'd probably always give them the heads up to talk to everyone. I mean, I did to Rachel too. I said, go talk to everyone.
Yeah.
Because they may ask you, did you talk to everyone? And then you will be able to say yes.
And then there's the bridge of you get one or two that say, no, I don't want to do that. Or I got a lot of company coming tonight back and forth for some reason.
Right.
On a party or something.
Right.
I mean, most neighbors, they can work that out. Like you say, oh, well, we'll just move barricade, let you in and out, it's not a big deal, but.
Yeah.
Liable to come back to us eventually if this starts to be more of a widespread thing, which it probably isn't going to be.
It could be hard to add signature lines on the back of the form.
Yeah.
But to that, I agree. We're taking somebody's word for it, obviously.
Yeah.
We trust your word, but yeah.
But there are situations in town where neighbors might not necessarily agree on it. And without that signature, we're just taking their word saying for it. It's not hard to add that to the form.
I just think it's worth looking into in the future myself. So.
Yep. Looks like staff is going to do that.
Yeah.
So moving on with this request form.
I would move that we approve the temporary street closure request for Rachel Morgan on July 4th.
Motion's been made to accept this request form. Is there a second?
I'll second that.
Seconded by Counselor Wagner. Would you call the roll, please, Stephanie?
Mayor Hobart?
Aye.
Wagner?
Aye.
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 Counselor Norman?
Aye.
Motion carries.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Have fun. We'll waste our invites, so. Stephanie, you'll notice.
Oh, now I gotta declare a conflict of interest.
Bucket six, and then we're gonna have a cherry pit spinning contest.
Oh, big doing. Thanks, Rachel.
Thank you.
Staff report, staff request for city hall closure. Looks like for July 3rd. So
it's all there in writing. They said, why not ask? Because there's only two of them.
We have a council meeting that night?
Well, so that's the other question that we had is that last
year we canceled that meeting. So we knew that that would be something that would be tied to this.
Yeah.
But that's ultimately up to you guys if that's what you want to do.
Go ahead.
It's already the 20th. The 4th is coming up pretty darn quickly, or the 3rd. Is there, I can't imagine there's a whole heck of a lot of things looming on.
I don't think currently we have anything in the folder for the meeting yet.
No, nothing that can, nothing that's pressing.
I won't be here.
What, pardon me?
I won't be here anyway, so it's up to you.
Oh. One down.
It would be. We don't know of anything that's like has to happen on the 3rd meeting, or we have a whole bunch of stuff in the folder, so.
Be off.
It's kind of up to you guys. I mean, granted, we'll have minutes, we'll have potentially a committee meetings report or something, but we don't have any ordinances or resolutions at this time yet.
Okay.
I won't be here either because that is my camping vacation. I'm going to be out of Renonia for the first time in 20 some years, so.
Ooh.
On the 4th, so.
Okay.
I thought you meant effort. I was like, you should get out.
Never leaves.
I never leave.
Ever.
Offs at Century every time.
Every time.
So I would move to close City Hall on Monday, July 3rd, and in conjunction, cancel our city council meeting.
So moved. Is there a second?
I'll second that.
Second by Counselor Ash. Would you call the roll, please, Stephanie?
Second.
I threw a curveball in.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Counselor Norman?
Aye.
Counselor Wagner?
Aye.
Counselor Webb?
Aye.
Counselor Ash?
Aye.
Mayor Hobart?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Yes, vacation.
Thanks, guys.
She's one of the two.
And it's my anniversary, so I would have been spicy anyways.
Oh, wow.
To not be with your husband.
Business from the departments. Doesn't look like it. Ordinances and resolutions. Resolution 2023-08, cemetery rules update.
Exactly how you were presenting them. I think you might have made some spelling corrections, but nothing changed from the last meeting.
Move to approve resolution number 2023-08, a resolution of the city of Vernonia adopting rules and regulations for the city for the Vernonia Memorial Cemetery and repealing resolution 2021-15.
So moved. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Seconded by Counselor Webb.
Mayor Hobart?
Aye.
Counselor Ash?
Aye.
Counselor Norman?
Aye.
Counselor Wagner?
Aye.
Okay. And the big one. Resolution 2023-09, adopting the fiscal year 2023-2024 budget for the city of Vernonia.
Move to approve resolution number 2023-09, resolution of the city council of the city of Vernonia, Oregon, adopting the fiscal year budget 2023-24, making appropriations, imposing the taxes, and categorizing the taxes for the fiscal year beginning July 1, 2023.
So moved. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Seconded by Counselor Ash.
Counselor Webb?
Aye.
Counselor Norman?
Aye.
Reichner?
Aye.
Aye.
Counselor Ash?
Aye.
Motion carried. Very difficult.
You're like, which one didn't I say? Right?
Mm-hmm. You there.
Resolution 2023-10, master fee schedule update, page 36.
Okay, so I can tell you all the things that changed in this. The first thing, parks fees, that was increased to $4. A parking pass to $50 more than everybody else pays. And that's based off the budget. Then the utility rates, those were adjusted per the rate calculator. And it's exactly how you guys saw it at the last meeting. And then the cemetery fees for the columbarium niches, as was discussed at the last meeting, were increased. It was $100. And that's it.
Okay, I will.
Oh. Dale?
Oh, I did have a brief conversation with Josette today. Last year, we waited till the books closed on the utility rates. I think when we had our discussion, we talked about doing that again this year, but
so
I think it's
we adopted them at the last meeting in June last year. I looked it up.
We looked it up today.
I think you might be thinking of.
And then we incorporated in, yeah, and then we incorporated into the policy that we weren't going to do the ad hoc committee anymore. We were just going to, the policy that you've just amended recently based on the over-the-counter money includes that we weren't going to have the ad hoc committee because that was kind of contentious 2 years ago that we didn't do it. Because this is the thing. If it's the cash on hand is down, are you going to raise the fee?
Well, technically we would have.
But that's what I'm saying. So if the cash on hand up by 10 bucks more than we had estimated when we put it into the calculator, are we going to lower the fee? I mean, that's the tinkering that we end up doing. And ultimately, if we collect a little bit more, it goes into the next year's calculator is kicked back. So that function happens.
Yes.
Right. It might collect, you know, 50 cents more from each customer over the course of the year or something. And it gets returned to them because it doesn't get charged for the next. Does that make sense? That's why we put, so We did look into it today because we were.
Oh, really?
We were talking about that. So.
Yeah, I'm surprised by that because I thought it was last year, because I know Ben and I were talking about there was a little, we did recognize a little bit of a shortfall because of that first month wasn't on the true rate.
Right. Because.
But I agree with you though. I know we've cut this pretty close. A little extra carryover is just going to roll into cash on hand in the next budget cycle. It's probably not a big deal.
Yeah.
I just know we seemed like we had talked about it in our budget, and I think I specifically asked Angie that too, so.
When we would be adopting it?
That we would wait till July to get the final.
So the tricky part is if you wait till July, you miss any of that rev. If you wait till the first meeting in July, any revenue coming in will be not changed this way. You'd be missing it for all of the days until you do adopt it.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's just a, and in the scheme of things, the best estimates have got us within $1,000 of a $500,000 budget. So that's pretty dang close, you know, money wise. It's not like we're bringing in, like in the old days, 11 grand every year that, you know, was, we didn't necessarily need, that was overage or something. So the tricky part we were also talking about is, should it not perform, or may, you know, in the 6 years we've been doing it with the calculator, 6-7 years, we've never had to come to council in the middle of the year and say it's not performing, raise the rate.
Right.
So the estimates have been pretty successful, because we've never really had to mid-year raise the rates to make the budget. That's kind of our, and should it be something egregious, we can bring you guys the master fee schedule and amend them in the month of July to make it meet if it's something really off of the estimate.
Yeah.
But I think, you know, if it's not really off the estimate, I don't know if it has as much value to kind of, because they have been posted. I mean, we did, you guys did kind of approve the rate that's been posted in the paper. So we'd have to do kind of a PR campaign if we're going to tweak it much away from that or not.
Right.
You know, increase it or something. So.
No, and I agree. I mean, I was thinking about today because we've cut it so close that for over even 20 grand, it's not a big deal.
It's going to go.
It's going to come out the next year. So.
Yeah.
But I just wanted to make that open, that because I think our minutes out of the budget discussion may, if somebody were to listen to them, it might preclude them to think that. I mean, I was under that impression.
Yeah.
So I'm fine with it. Wait.
Okay.
Okay. Anything else?
All right, I will move to adopt resolution number 2020-10, a resolution providing for adoption of a new and revised master fee schedule and rescinding resolution 2022-13.
So moved. Is there a second?
I'll second that.
Seconded by Councilor Webb.
Councilor Biker?
Aye.
Councilor Ash?
Aye.
Councilor Webb?
Aye.
Councilor Norman?
Aye.
Mayor Hobart?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Thank you. Any correspondence tonight? Okay. City Administrator report.
Okay.
You're fine.
Okay. Okay. So still haven't got a date for the testing of the old dump. So we'll wait. They said early summer, and I'm like, it's early summer. Come on. The demolition project. So because we will be having the Great American Bash, and just to get the dumpsters lined up, we're going to start the 10th of July in taking down the grandstands. And then once we kind of get in there and see what material could be salvageable, we'll post on Facebook and stuff of a date. People can sign waivers and come take something of what we get that will kind of pull apart without being super brittle or dangerous to access. Kind of related to that, we got to kind of kill, Rachel didn't mention it when she was here, but she had applied for the seniors for a grant for elder exercise equipment. And she was successful in that. So the seniors will be signing the grant agreement because the money came to them, but we're going to be, and Steve, I wish Steve had been here too, because he had always talked about having kind of a senior path through the trees and some sort of like benches or something for the seniors. So in her grant, we have three pieces of outdoor exercise equipment. One's like a little bridge. One's a sit-down bike that's all outdoor, tamper-proof. They can't really mess it up. And then some kind of swivel equipment that we're going to be kind of putting in the little grove of trees down there. Like, kind of coincides with the grandstand, is it has kind of a path that they could walk. The seniors could walk a shorter path, shorter than the track. And so we're going to be using the equipment that we have on site to tear down the grandstands for peeling the sod and preparing that path, and getting fabric and then compacted rock over it before Jamboree, so that the Jamboree activities don't negate the work we are doing with that. So that's kind of exciting. So Steve will get his senior activity things, and we'll use the equipment as it's on site, and then we can get that moving. And then they're going to also, I believe, put kind of a bar. It will look more like a handrail, but they'll be putting a bar for senior exercise in between the two doors of the flex room in that kind of dead zone there, because they are doing, having probably 25 regular seniors that are taking exercise class at the senior center. So we're trying to get them other areas in the community that they can also do exercise. So pretty excited Rachel was successful at that grant. The request to apply for the lake docks, we don't need a resolution to apply for the lake docks. So that statement that said it was coming second meeting of June, there is no resolution. We just apply. I have a letter from the Isaac Walton League via Councillor Webb, who is the head honcho of that, from a biologist, and then some estimates from Topper Industries. I'm going to get another bid because Topper Industries, their bid was very expensive. But I think we can have the aluminum frame docks done more reasonably. I'm going to check with a local fabricator, and then Oregon Marine Construction is the group that did the diving for us, and they also build. So if anybody knows any other fabricators that I should potentially get a bid from, throw their name or number my way, and I will send them kind of our specs of what we're looking for. We're basically replacing the exact same dock. We're going to reuse the aluminum handrails, so we don't have to spend for that. And then the ramps are aluminum and already have the grating on them, so those aren't necessary to replace. The only addition to this, different than our existing docks, is we are planning for a 4-foot by 30-foot walk-on dock. They're calling it a catwalk, but basically a walk-on dock that's adjacent to the boat ramp. So someone can put their boat in, tie it up, come up the dock, and move their vehicle. So that would be the only add-on for the project. And that, we're working up finishing that application because it's due by June 10th or July 10th. ODOT, I know a lot of you, if you live on the east side, you've seen the guardrail that somebody, I'm sure, doing a burnout hit, and you know.
No,
it was just not there one night, lots of loud, you know, trucks going by, and then it was there the next morning. So ODOT has been notified of that. They're super busy and they're putting it on their schedule, but I don't have a timeline of when that those will be replaced. Electrical, we're working with Blake to, so the one thing that didn't get switched over in City Hall and the police department was the phone system. We're still on Ziply. And that's ridiculously expensive. We want to be on GorgNet because it's way cheaper, but we're waiting for IT and the electrical, because it's low voltage that needs to be re-pulled to all of the phone outlets, because the cable that regular phone uses, they now use a Cat 5 or something different. So we have to re-kind of string down to these. But it kind of coincides with server replacement. We had to basically, the server in City Hall and the server at the police department, because of their record keeping and the crimes and kind of the federal rules, need to be two separate servers. So we were already doing some of that work in that separation in this upcoming fiscal year. So we're looking at that for the electrical. And then he is still working on the these items. And then depending on what the pole looks like, pull out the grandstands, we may, you know, put a plate on top of it so water doesn't go down it if it's hollow on the inside, and reuse one of those poles as the camera pole, refashion it and attach it to the ground, kind of at the front of Spencer Park is where the camera pole should be. Storm Ready City, I haven't gotten an ETA for their sign delivery. I'm still working on the food bank grant. So July 1, we can purchase the shelf-stable food. They got the $125,000 for shelf-stable protein, other foods, personal care items, and then their cabinets and their refrigerator units. So we're hoping to get kind of all of those after July 1. We didn't want to do it before then because it messes with what you guys saw in the budget. So after July 1, we'll be purchasing those. We are buying a number of things local. We met with Katie Potter and Randy Perro and Stacy Pond, who's their manager, to see what was close in price and we could benefit a local establishment by purchasing through them. And then there's some things that aren't close at all, and to be good stewards of the money, we need to purchase out of town. So we gave them a spreadsheet and went kind of shopping, Angie Taylor and I, with the items we'd want them to price out for us. So a lot of their items look pretty reasonable and similar in cost, even with what they need to get it there. And so we're going to be buying some of that. And that's kind of all I got, unless you guys have questions for me.
So the bike hub at the lake, that's county?
Yes. Okay. The bike hub.
Yeah.
Something.
The repair station.
Yes.
Yeah. Somebody vandalized the air pump.
Oh, okay.
The handle completely gone out of it. And then the Schrader valve, they pushed the pin out.
Okay.
Whatever, and it's gone.
Okay.
So yeah, I didn't know if.
I'll call them and I believe they have parts. They may just, depending on the damage, they may pull out the unit, swap it with one, and then fix it there. But yeah,
some of those things you have to really vandal proof. It just amazes me. So one more if I can. So the lake ramp grant idea is going through parks, right?
For the rent, for what?
For the lake, the
dock?
The ramp for the boat launch?
No.
It's not?
Okay. No.
So I was down there, there was a front wheel drive car, and he put chains on his car to get in and out. He said, yeah, he says, I was here last week, and he said, I spun all the way out of here. So he put chains on the front end to get out. So, you know, it probably discourages some people from using our lake because it's just a little steep and loose rock, you know, and it's, you know, as people are spinning, it's starting to get a little choppy now. And the guys did a pretty good job of straightening it up, but.
Yeah, so someone in the car was offloading a boat?
Yeah.
Okay, like a canoe or a real boat? They had a hitch on it? A
little small drift boat.
Okay.
That, you know, regular trailer and a little small.
Yeah.
Like a 12-foot drift boat. And you know, that's what they have. And
yeah.
So I just was, you know.
So the what?
You got a lot on your plate, but I just was like, how are we going to resolve this? I mean, we I know we're talking about it, and our engineers have experience on this, so
yeah,
it's a matter of putting in for a grant, I suppose. So
to redo the boat launch.
Yeah, the boat launch.
So one of the ideas, and I still haven't found it in the old files, but someone said at some point the boat launch was supposed to come from where we're saying the campground would be. Is that true?
It's in the Parks Master Plan.
Yeah.
But no, they said they looked into it and there should be documents on it. And
it's in the Parks Master Plan. I saw it in there.
No, the mention of it, but not an actual design of it. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
So, I mean, one option is we could always, when we go, are you thinking like paving it or what?
Well, remember we talked about we would probably do a pour in place concrete slab.
And then
you pour
yes,
on top of
yeah,
it,
yeah.
The other one
yeah.
You excavate out. You
yeah, there's nothing, this is just going to be floating and anchored on the one end. So we
for the dock.
Yeah, so we can move it.
I'm talking ramp.
Yeah, we haven't added that to our scheme of things because we already have a parks grant, and potentially where we go for that grant would either be ODFW, which we're currently asking for the docks, or it'd be OPRD, which we're currently in a grant with the campground.
Well, actually, remember we talked, it was Marine Board has grants.
Oh, okay.
Because
well,
all the boaters pay fees, and some of those fees is for boating access.
Okay.
That's Marine Board grant.
Yeah, so we haven't even started that because we have too many grants on our plate right now.
Yeah, that's an issue.
So I just meant like we could, when we go for that, we could unhook the floating catwalk, do whatever, and then hook it back where it works. Yeah. Yeah, and Robert, because he's still doing springboard, he probably hasn't even, yeah.
Just something I guess we have to just keep on our radar.
Yep.
And it is one of the items on our list now, I think.
Sheree, you had something?
Yeah, I was just curious, and I forgot to ask you earlier when I was in, but weren't we going to paint the Connex?
Yeah, so I've been in talks with Tiffany. Mm-hmm. Of course, she wants money to have a street artist do it. And then I had a local kid artist. I kind of talked over with them, like, hey, if we bought you the paint, even just to make it look like forested trees, mm-hmm. right? And he was interested in that as a summer project. So it might.
Even just a solid, like, some shade of green that blends in would be.
Yeah, it does look like, yeah, it does look like loading zone.
Yeah.
Councilor Wagner?
Since you mentioned a mural for that, I wish I'd grabbed a picture of it. I did not. I'll try to get one. In Wisconsin, they had a really awesome mural on the side of a building of loggers on the logs. And if you're talking about putting something by the lake, that would be very cool to have that specific.
Something of that theme. Okay.
That's yeah. What happened there.
Yeah, exactly. That's why. And I really wanted to grab a picture. It was in this little town in Wisconsin that I was in.
Okay.
I'll see if I can find
yeah, it. Yeah. So I am talking with them finance wise. And that's the thing with the Portland Street Art Alliance is typically you tell them a theme and they kind of come up with their own thing. Sometimes it's not what you're thinking. So if we want to commission someone to do something specific, that'd be good to have kind of a picture of it so I could show that around. Okay. So, or if even you know the little town, I could call their city manager and say, hey, go get me a picture of that.
I'll just call Deb.
Okay.
See if she can get by there.
Yeah. But yeah, Tiffany was like, yeah, we'd love to do it. We'd love to come out to Front Onion and do more. And I'm like, that was a lot of money when we did it through Colback, and we don't really have that money right now. So thank you. But unless they want to do it pro bono or for free, we're a little stuck. But yeah, no, I drove by it today and I was like, oh, it does look like a, like. Yeah,
and I mean, because it's in an already like busy
spot. Yeah, it'd be different if it kind of disappeared. Yeah, I was thinking that. I was like, what could it look like if the blackberries were there and like something, even if it's trees, but yeah. And maybe the student, it's not even a student, it's out of high school artist that's a citizen here, but maybe we could give them the picture and they could pull it off. you know, if we buy the paint, then they have their art somewhere.
It was a simplistic but stunning.
Yeah.
But that needs to be in Vernonia.
Well, and I've seen it too, where you kind of get an outline and you shoot it on the building and then you.
Oh, yeah.
You mark where all the things are. So you aren't kind of, if you're not used to doing huge scale, you can kind of draw it smaller. Someone approves it and then you shoot it on the side. I've done a lot of sets for the school district that way, where you kind of like, you want a castle? Great. We draw a castle and then shoot it. And then the castle can be this big and it's all proportional. So I'll look into that.
Okay. I'll get you.
You'll get me a pic.
I would think the museum would have even some local pictures.
Yeah. Maybe we could replicate something like that and just put it in, do the outline and shoot it. Yeah.
Maybe Austin East.
Go up to the museum and look around.
That's what Donald says.
Yeah.
Yeah. I can ask Tobe if she's got any good shots of the lake with the guys walking on the logs or something. Okay.
Okay. Anything else for the city administrator? Okay. Thank you, Josette.
Yep.
Any items from counselors? Yeah.
I did one of my walkthroughs on there in the McNair Forest.
You've spotted that, though, but it sticks.
I took my log counters with me and counted dead versus alive. I came up with 86% survival so far. Yeah, the deer didn't do us any favors. We'll try to resurrect that this winter. The town there where that sawdust pile is, the vetch now is head high. I'm gonna have to go through there and weed whack another time through there. And then I watershed council planted trees along the river down by the primitive campground down in those areas, trying to get some conifers going. And I kind of took that on too. I've weed whacked that twice. And now I'm kind of having regrets because the second time I weed whacked it, evidently the deer followed my paths into every tree and ate the tops out of them.
They're like, oh, this is where Dale said.
Yeah, I was like, come on.
Yeah.
And, but yeah, the canary grass is over the top of them again. So it's really hard to grow trees in riparian areas and in areas, I mean, I just can't believe that vetch down there, the thistle and a vetch. And I mean, literally, I was, when I weed whacked, I just whacked around the trees and not as I was going, because I just stepping through the small thistles. But now it's like a wall. I should have been weed whacking everything to get through. So, yeah. And then I did do, I don't know if you noticed, was that you honked at me?
No.
Oh, I went up and did aura. I went around and got all the trees. I used my blade so you don't touch the trees.
Okay. Awesome.
Probably could use somebody to do a little handwork, but I got those all kind of opened up too. So, and not too bad of survival up there too. So
yeah.
Conifers are doing pretty good. And all the ones that are tubed, you know, and then the deer aren't bothering. So,
yeah.
And I think all but two of the ash trees survived. There's two dead ash trees.
Okay, I did see the ones.
Nothing leafed out.
Yeah.
So, and I can only find the one viney maple.
I know. I'm gonna have to put them back in and then cage them. They're too tender leaf. They like them.
Delicious.
Yeah. Right.
You're like everything.
Yeah.
And we're getting a whole bunch of new ones. I got three new ones in my yard running around and other people are seeing them all over town.
They've been on the hill every night, the last three nights, all spotted.
I'm starting to see, I've read some literature that when densities get so high, they start having a preponderance towards males. And I'm starting to see that show up with in my area. I mean, I've got quite a little buck population coming from last year's fawns and the ones that were yearlings before. I mean, there were four or five of them all in one group there.
All of them.
Yeah. Don't see very many female yearlings. I mean, that's where you can really, even in the fawns, once they get older, you can see the nubs, but.
Yeah.
So maybe they're starting to kind of self-regulate here a little bit. It's kind of interesting to watch.
Well, when I, like last week at school, I was driving by and the Catholic Church had like a little bachelor party there with a whole bunch of little boys sitting in.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, okay then. Yeah.
Five of them all together. And as much as I complain about no deer out in the woods, and it's just so ironic being inside town, they're really starting to become a nuisance. I mean, they eat everything.
Yeah.
So, and almost like I see them eating on things this year that I haven't seen them eating on before. And it's like, everything's lush. Everything's available right now. Why are you still targeting
right
these other things? So I know the Richard and David down there, the deer got into their cherry tree that they got in.
Oh.
Yeah. You know, so
they had a little, put a little scent out around their cherry
tree. Yeah, he was gonna hang some Irish soap or something.
Irish spring or whatever. Yeah.
All you got.
Anything else? Action item summary.
Okay, so staff's gonna take just a little look-see at other cities' policies for street closures, and then potentially put the signature lines on the back. I'm going to call the county about the bike hub station and let them know that it was vandalized, see what they want to do about it. Put marine board for the boat ramp grant, future grant, on our list. And then Susan's going to send me a pic, and I'm going to keep moving forward with the mural on the Connex this summer. Some sort of, even if we just get it a blendable green.
Yeah. Cam.
Yeah.
Okay. And everyone look at the upcoming meetings. Of course, we canceled the July 3rd meeting.
I will have our guys' forms for the evaluation available on July 5th. So I'll email you, and then I'll also have them hard copied here.
Okay. Next council meeting will be July 17th. So everyone have a safe, joyous holiday, 4th of July. And I'll adjourn this meeting at 8 o'clock. Meeting adjourned.